Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. My today's recipe is a Korean dish known as Korean fried chicken. The chicken in this dish has a crispy outer coating with a thick, spicy, sweet sauce. So let's look into the ingredient list now. My first ingredient is of course chicken, and here I have boneless thigh chicken, 1 kilo, and I have cut them into small 1-inch size pieces. 1/2 cup of corn flour, 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour, and 1/2 cup of rice flour. And here I have 1 teaspoon of ginger powder, 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper powder, and of course some salt to taste. To prepare the sauce, we need 2 tablespoons of garlic chopped, 1/2 cup of tomato ketchup, 2 teaspoons of soy sauce, and today I am using the light soy sauce, spoons of apple cider vinegar, but if you don't have it, you can use the regular one also. And this is a Korean hot pepper paste known as gochujang, and I am using 1/2 cup of it, equivalent to my ketchup. 2 teaspoons of honey, but if you don't want honey, you can use some sugar also. Around 2 teaspoons of sesame oil for cooking, and some sesame seeds for garnishing. And here I have 1 cup of chicken stock. So to start off, here is my rice flour, and I'll add in around 1/2 cup of water to the rice flour and make a thick batter out of it. So this is the rice flour mixture. You can see it is not very runny, pretty thick batter. And we are going to add this to the chicken along with the spices. First goes in the garlic powder, ginger powder, some salt to taste, red chili powder, black pepper powder, and the rice flour mixture. And we'll mix all the ingredients well with our hands. And here are my chicken pieces, all well coated. And I'll let it rest for 10 minutes. My chicken has been sitting for around 10 minutes now. And now we'll prepare the coating before frying the chicken. For that, I'll add in the corn flour and all-purpose flour together in a plate. Give it a good mix together. And now I'm going to take individual pieces of chicken and coat them in this mixture well. This will actually give a very nice and crispy coating for our chickens. Dust off the extra flour mixture. So here are my chicken pieces, all well coated, and now it's ready to be fried. So we'll move on to the gas stove now. I've already added oil in a frying pan to deep fry my chicken pieces, and to check if my oil is ready or not, I'll insert this toothpick. And if you can see, there are some bubbles forming around the toothpick. That means my oil has the perfect temperature to fry my chicken pieces. So I'll add in the pieces now. And since today we are using boneless chicken pieces, it won't take too long to fry. It's been around 2 minutes now, and I'm going to flip the chicken pieces. And today I'll be frying my chicken pieces twice so that they get a very crispy outer coating. So we won't brown them right now. We'll cook this chicken pieces for another 2-3 minutes. It's been another 3 minutes now, and I'm going to remove the chicken pieces. In a kitchen towel. And I'll continue with the rest of my chicken pieces now. While my chickens are frying, we'll start preparing the sauce for the chicken. In my pan, I'm adding 2 teaspoons of sesame oil,
My oil is hot now, and to it I'm going to add in the chopped garlic. I soak the garlic for a minute or two. As you can see, the garlic has started turning slightly brownish in color. At this point, we'll add in all the sauces. First goes in the ketchup, soy sauce, apple cider vinegar. Next goes in the gochujang, which is the Korean hot pepper paste. This is easily available in any kind of Asian grocery stores. And if you can't find it at all, you can use some red chili paste instead also. Mix it well. And we'll add in the chicken stock along with the honey. Mix it well and we'll allow this to come to a boil. My sauce has been cooking for around 5 minutes now, and you can see this is the consistency we want, and it is ready. So I'm going to switch off the gas and start with the double frying of the chicken now. So here are my chicken pieces which are fried once, and now I'm going to fry them again. This time we'll cook it for another 5 minutes or till they are nice and golden brown in color. It's been 5 minutes now, and you can see they are nice and golden in color, and there's a lot of crunch in them also. So I'm going to remove it from heat now. So here is my fried chicken and the Korean sauce. The only last thing that is left is we have to mix them together. So what I'll do is I'll pour the sauce over my chicken pieces here. If you want, you can individually brush them with the sauce also. I'll add in more sauce. Try to coat all the pieces well with the sauce. So here is my Korean fried chicken ready, and I have garnished it with a little bit of sesame seed and some spring onion greens. My Korean fried chicken is ready, and friends, I bet if you eat one, you just can't stop with it. So do give this recipe a try, and don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you for watching.